Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. Sometimes we get questions about seismic activity on other planets, whether or not earthquakes occur on other planets or only on Earth. Recently, NASA came out with a report that a magnitude 4.7 earthquake actually occurred on Mars, and that was on 4 May 2022. So we looked at the planetary configuration on 4 May 2022, and indeed, Mars was in an exact conjunction with Venus and Mercury. And we know statistically that Mercury and Venus, especially combined, can result in a larger seismic activity. On Earth, these two planets account for 87% of major earthquakes magnitude 7.5 and larger. A very interesting observation, and NASA confirmed that the Mars quake was due to tectonic activity, not due to a meteorite or anything. It's a very interesting observation. Today, 8 years ago, a magnitude 7.5 earthquake occurred in Hindu Kush region, Afghanistan. We warned for a larger earthquake at the time, 21st of October, about 5 days before the earthquake occurred, because of critical planetary geometry. Mind you, we did not have the SGI algorithm at the time. We began to develop that in 2017, but we did recognize the critical geometry. That was the first year that we actually started to do earthquake forecasts. And as you can see on this SGI graph, critical planetary geometry occurred with Mercury, the red peaks, a high red peak, followed by another red peak, purple peak, and then we had this major earthquake. This was a clear convergence of critical planetary geometry. Look specifically at this form, a high red peak followed by another red peak, and then the earthquake. In 2017, we started to develop the SGI algorithm to visualize the relationship between larger earthquakes and critical planetary geometry. That was in July 2017. Immediately, when a magnitude 7.7 earthquake occurred east of Kamchatka, we could test the SGI algorithm. And as you can see, a high red peak and another red peak preceded the magnitude 7.7 earthquake, very similar to what happened in October 2015. This is an obvious relationship between critical planetary geometry, Mercury, they are the red peaks, and purple, they are peaks with indicating Venus. Very important. Okay, now let's have a look what happened in the previous time frame on our SGI graph. We see some clustering of stronger earthquakes, minor clustering with the planetary conjunctions. Like I said, the planetary conjunctions were spread out over the week, so it was difficult to make any estimates like the next 2 or 3 days will be very critical. When we have a tight convergence, it is easier to say that the next 2 or 3 days will be critical. That was not the case. We had them spread out over the week, so we had some minor clustering of stronger earthquakes. The strongest clustering occurred with the lunar peak on 22-23 October and seismic activity peaked magnitude 6.1 at the Kermadec Islands, New Zealand. And then this morning, two strong earthquakes following a planetary peak with Mercury and also a higher lunar peak. We actually lowered the magnitude threshold by 0.1 to include magnitude 5.5 earthquakes. And as you can see, this is what happened. There was not all that much activity, some stronger seismic activity, but not really much. So that is what we had in the previous time frame. Let's get on with the next time frame because it is going to be very critical. As you can see, we have a convergence coming up of no less than 5 planetary conjunctions from 28 to 30 October. This is going to be very critical because it's going to converge with full moon and with a very high lunar peak, and this is because the moon will be in a conjunction with Mars, Mercury and Jupiter virtually at the same time. The reason for this is, if we look at the solar system, a near quadruple conjunction with Mars, Mercury, Earth and Jupiter, almost in a straight line. And that happens from the 28th to the 30th of October. And the moon is going to be in a conjunction with Jupiter, with Mercury, with Venus, and also with the Sun. This all happens in a very short time, and that's what makes it very critical. Very strong electromagnetic currents will be generated by this planetary and lunar geometry. And we can anticipate really large seismic activity as a result. I would say around the 31st of October, give or take one day, is probably going to be most critical. We do not know exactly when large earthquakes are going to occur due to this planetary geometry, but I expect around the 31st, give or take one day. It could be earlier, around the time of the full moon already, or just following the full moon. It's difficult to make an estimate there, but expect larger seismic activity. I certainly expect a clustering of stronger earthquakes. We're going to use a threshold of magnitude 5.6 and larger, and we usually see this clustering of these earthquakes following that critical planetary geometry. So let's see what happens. Be on extra alert. We cannot pinpoint every potential region on the planet. So if you are in an earthquake prone area, be on extra alert in the days following this critical planetary geometry, this tight convergence. Be on watch. We have a high lunar peak on the 1st of November, and that is due to lunar geometry with Venus and Neptune. And this is because Earth will be between Venus and Neptune on the 3rd, 4th of November. And then we see another clustering. It looks less critical at this point, a clustering of critical planetary geometry, a few planetary conjunctions, and also some right angle geometry involving Venus. I will explain that geometry later on in the first week of November, because we need to see what is going to happen after the quadruple conjunction from 28 to 30 October. We have to wait and see how Earth is going to respond, and from there we are going to look at the next convergence on 4-5 November. This is a very interesting week that we're going to have, so be on extra alert. If you look at atmospheric fluctuations, on the 22nd, we marked some regions over the Middle East and in the Indian Ocean. It wasn't really a very strong atmospheric fluctuation, but we could see some moderate to strong seismic activity as a result. Then yesterday, that was a significant fluctuation, and it marked regions near the Andaman Islands and also to the south. You see this red line, which is perpendicular to the plane of the ecliptic. It's very significant. And also to the north, close to Hindu Kush region, I suspect that there could be a larger seismic activity coming up near the Himalayan mountains, China perhaps, but also maybe between the region Nepal and Afghanistan that were recently hit by stronger earthquakes. Nepal had a 5.9 recently, and of course the four stronger earthquakes in Afghanistan. It is possible that the region in between, Hindu Kush region, potentially can have larger seismic activity coming up. This was a significant convergence. It indicates a potential of larger seismic activity. We continue to record atmospheric fluctuations, and we have to wait and see what happens in the coming days. You can look up our social media channels and also our website, where we update with new atmospheric fluctuations if they occur. This is the update for now. It's going to be a very critical week. The next several days we're going to have this very critical planetary geometry, and there can be large seismic activity as a result. So if you are in an earthquake prone area, be sure to have an earthquake plan. Be on extra alert. This is the update for now. Stay safe. Until next time.